Hi students, how are you? I hope you are doing well in your studies. I am Shiva, faculty of physics. Today we are going to discuss one more concept for 8th standard students, that is electric field due to the dipole but for any arbitrary point. So here, before going to discuss this topic, we can see some key ideas that are helpful to understand this topic. So first of all, first key idea. So see the vector equation, that is C bar is equal to A bar plus B bar. So we are adding A bar with B bar. So in the graphical representation, how we can represent it? So we can add A bar's head to the B bar's tail. At that time, the resultant vector C bar, how we can draw? The resultant vector C bar is drawn in the manner such that C bar tail is at the tail of A bar, C bar head is at the head of B bar. Now assume yourself, theta is the angle between A bar and B bar. So remember, this angle theta here is not head to tail, it is tail to tail. How we can visualize it is tail to tail? Shift the vector B bar, shift the vector B bar, that is parallel shifting, such that B bar's tail must be coincided with the A bar's tail. At that time, what is the angle between A bar and B bar? The angle between A bar and B bar is theta. That's why here I am saying this is the angle between tail to tail, between A bar and B bar, not head to tail. Okay, so suppose if you want to calculate the magnitude of C bar, so how can we calculate the magnitude of C bar in terms of the magnitudes of A bar and B bar? Suppose say A is the magnitude of A bar, B is the magnitude of B bar, C is the magnitude of C bar. At that time, we know the expression for the magnitude of the resultant vector C bar is A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. Okay, suppose here we are taking this value of theta is 90 degrees. Nothing but A bar vector is perpendicular to B bar vector. At that time, what we can write? So put here theta is 90 degrees, then we will get C is equal to square root of A square plus B square. C is equal to square root of A square plus B square, and the corresponding diagram we can see as in this pattern. So this is A bar, this is B bar, this is C bar. Okay, clearly we are seeing now here A bar is perpendicular to B bar. At that time, the magnitude of C bar, now what we can say, square root of A square plus B square. Okay, now go for second key idea here. So we know the electric field at the axial point P of the dipole, when the point P lies at the distance r from the center of the dipole, is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2 P by r cube. So if you want to see the derivation of this expression, one time go back to the previous video, there we have proved it. Okay, so remember, at that time clearly we found the direction of the E bar is same as the direction of P bar. The direction of the E bar is same as the direction of the P bar. That's why if you want to write this expression in terms of vector equation, now we can write it, E bar is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2 P bar by R cube. Okay, so now recall this key idea also. Now one more point here. So this is some point P, but this point P where we are seeing? This point P we are seeing on the perpendicular bisector of this dipole, and this point P lies at the distance r. Now what is the electric field at this point? So the electric field at this point now, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into P by R cube. So if you want to know the derivation behind the result, one time go back to the previous video and we have the chance to see this derivation.
Again, here one more point. Clearly, we are seeing na E bar direction is opposite to P bar. So E bar is left, P bar is right. Now express this equation in terms of vector. Then how we can write E bar is equal to minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into P by R cube. So that is vector equation. Okay. So here we are taking this point on the axial line of the dipole. Again, we are taking this point P on the perpendicular bisector of the dipole. Now we can take some arbitrary point, okay, as shown in figure. So this is also one dipole having the same length what we are taking in the previous two key areas. But here, what is the point now we are taking here? This point P not lying on the axis of dipole. This point P not lying on the perpendicular bisector of the dipole. This point P exactly you are seeing at some angle. So this is theta. So theta is nothing but the angle between the line connecting this point P with center of the dipole for P bar direction. Nothing but here theta represents angle between OP and P bar. Angle between OP and P bar. Okay, now at this point we want to calculate the resultant electric field. How can we calculate? Now this is the P bar. P bar what now? Dipole moment. Dipole moment is vector or scalar vector. Dipole moment, how we can represent its magnitude? We can say Q into 2L. What is the direction? Minus Q to plus Q. Now in this case, since it is a vector, now resolve the dipole moment. Suppose you can resolve it. Suppose I am resolving here, this is one more component of this dipole moment. So what is this dipole moment? From the knowledge of vector resolution, in 6th standard we studied, na? From the knowledge of that vector resolution concept, here what we can write? P bar component in this direction we can write as P cos theta. Okay, in the perpendicular direction we can write as P sin theta. So in this direction P cos theta, in the perpendicular direction P sin theta. Okay, one time you can visualize this is P cos theta, na? P cos theta also vector. Vector now you are seeing in this direction. Nothing but we can visualize here you are seeing one dipole. Okay, in this direction we can visualize one dipole with the dipole movement P cos theta. On the dipole only you are seeing this point P. Nothing but for the dipole with dipole movement P cos theta, this point P behaves like what type of point? Axial point. Again I am repeating, this P cos theta behaves like a dipole and this point P behaves like what type of point? Axial point for this dipole with dipole moment P cos theta. So that's why in the previous result here clearly we know, na? So for the axial point, what is the electric field? This is the expression. Okay, now utilize this result. Here we are seeing, na, clearly this electric field is directed away from the P bar along the axial line. See here, P bar is along the axial line, E bar also along the axial line only. That's why here we can write now this one also away from this axial line, this is ER. Okay, and again see the situation for this dipole, for the point lying on the perpendicular bisector, E bar is opposite to P bar. Okay, in the same manner this P sin theta also we can visualize as, okay, this P sin theta also we can visualize as one dipole with the dipole moment P sin theta. So for this dipole with dipole moment P sin theta, this point P behaves like what type of point? Equatorial point. That's why this is again what now? This is also one more vector with electric field magnitude say E theta. Okay, so here clearly you are seeing, na, ER is perpendicular to E theta. Okay, that's why the angle is 90 degrees. Now what is ER? So in order to write this ER expression, use this derivation result. Okay, what we have proved previously. Now here we can write ER is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2 into here our dipole, that azimuth dipole. So from here to here we are assuming na? This azimuth dipole having the dipole moment what? P cos theta. Now substitute here, 2p replaces with p cos theta. So same equation. Okay, but here I am replacing this p with what? P cos theta r cube. Okay, one more thing now. Here we are seeing this is p sin theta. Na? What is p sin theta? This point p lies on the equatorial point. Now we can utilize this result. So what is e theta? So e theta is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into. So this is p sin theta divided by r cube. Okay, so since er is vector, e theta also a vector, both vectors are perpendicular to each other. So that's why what is the resultant electric field? So the resultant electric field now we can write as E r square plus E theta square. Substitute these results. Okay. So E r and E theta now you can substitute here. Clearly we are seeing some are common terms na. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 by, so P by r cube. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught common. P by R cube also common. Let us take them out directly. So now what we can write here? So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into P by R cube square root of 4 cos square theta plus sin square theta. Okay. So now in this case, suppose I want to express, it is not in terms of sine cos, suppose I want to express this one in terms of totally cos theta, then what we can write? So replace sine square theta with 1 minus cos square theta. Now what we can write again? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into P by R cube square root of 4 cos square theta plus 1 minus cos square theta. 4 cos square theta minus cos square theta, 3 cos square theta. 3 cos square theta plus 1. Now here what we can write finally? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into P by R cube into square root of 3 cos square theta plus 1. So this is the resultant electric field at an arbitrary point of the dipole where the point P lies at the distance r from the center of the dipole at an angle theta with the direction of the dipole moment P bar. Okay students, this is today's lecture. In the next lecture, we will continue this topic as part 2. At that time, we will discuss what is the direction of the resultant electric field at this point P. Okay, I hope you understood this lecture well. In the next video, we will meet with this continuation.